Hey guys, Chris Funk out here this morning on the Chattahoochee River. Got a few kayaks on the landing we're going to talk about today. You can see I've got a Coosa HD in front of me, I've got a Cuda HD behind me, and a Mayfly back there. We're going to talk about all of them, but I'm going to try to split them up into two videos. That way you guys don't get absolutely bored to death. So we're going to talk about the Coosa HD and the Cuda HD first. You know, to me, there is no perfect kayak. There's nothing perfect. You know, like we talked about before, they would be super lightweight, super cheap, super fast, super stable, and there's just no such thing as that type of a boat. But there are boats that are better for you. And that's what the discussion we want to have today is, what's going to be the best boat for what you do with it? And I cannot stress enough to demo. Put your butt in the boat and do with it what you do, and then make that decision for yourself. I know not everybody has that luxury, and that's kind of why you have guys like me around to help answer questions. But all I can do is lead you to your own conclusion. You got to choose the best boat for you. Let's talk about these. All right, one thing you notice in their stock configuration is there's a similarity in the cockpit as far as you've got a console in both of them. The one thing that sold me on the HD in that aspect was the removability of this one. Now, you guys know that I don't care for this and I don't use them. I prefer the open floor. But for somebody that needs to like, you mount electronics, you can put gear here, you know, it's got the line spooler thing. The fact that it's removable is very much a selling point for me on this boat because I love that open floor. Now, I'm not a fan of any type of console between my feet, but if I was going to have a console between my feet, this is the way I would want it. They've done a really good job reinforcing this lid. It's got tracks on the top so I can mount electronics, rod holders, whatever I want. I've got a super thick plate up here that I can mount, you know, the heavier electronics up to 7-9 inch screens, whatever you feel like you need to fish with. Opens up, it's got the tray in the middle so I can put bags of soft plastics, I can put my day's worth of gear, whatever I want to in there. And of course it's removable so you can pull that out and put rods in the hull. You know, if I was gonna have a console, this is the way I'd want it to be. The front hatches on these boats are awesome. I mean, they're cavernous, you know, we like them a whole lot. I gotta admit, I love these new latches. That to me is just so slick. I don't like, you know, I don't have bungee to hook onto, so I'm not fooling with that part of it. Now the bungee up here, of course, this is not stock bungee. This is my bride's boat. The bungee up here is nice to put the paddle under, but this Hypalon sheet right here is so easy to slide a paddle blade under. It's almost intuitive. You don't even really have to think about it. You know, so there's plenty of space up front, but to me, my knot, I love these latches. This is a great design, and I'd like to see that incorporated in all the boats. Looking at the back end of them, you see the back hatches. Now, they're both small. Probably this one's a little easier to use just because of the odd shape. You can get gear in there a little bit better. The round one's never been real easy for me to get gear into. The tank wells, you know, on this one, I would have loved to have seen all this tank well, but I'm not the designer, so... you can definitely see where the rod holders, you know, these are of course angled back so that you can go low underneath trees, and that's real nice when you're moving on a river, not having to worry about your rod sticking up too high. This one easily adds the third and fourth rod holders on there, so you can have literally bristling like a porcupine out there if you want with the number of rods. I mean, they're both very, very fishy boats. For the seating systems, you can see that the Coosa HD still uses the strap system, and I really love that as far as still having the two high, the three low positions so you can adjust on the water if you need to. You can trim the boat to perform like you want it to. It can be as loose or as tight as you want it to be. High and low for being able to get down out of trouble if the conditions deteriorate or if you just need that extra stability. You know, I like that system a whole lot. The strap to me has always been a problem because of getting stuff in and out from underneath the seat. Now the Cuda HD has addressed that with the new track system and the pins. Two pins, seats in, seats out. I love that. High, low, same thing. Two pins. To move it back and forth, it's got the two thumb screws that allow it to slide back and forth on the track, which, you know, probably 7 inches of adjustment to allow you to trim the boat as well. To me, I love this system, and I would love to see all the boats go to this system, but that's just my opinion. You know, for me, for what I do out here on moving water, generally speaking, the dam's running, things are moving, it's hard to beat this boat. You know, just being able to go from a super maneuverable boat to a boat that tracks good. Now, it doesn't track like the Cuda HD does, but it tracks good. So if I'm on, you know, open water, I don't feel outgunned. The stability on this boat is really, really nice. As far as just being able to stand up, fish, throw a cast net, you know, shoot a bow, do what you want to, I like that a whole lot. Another real positive to me on the Coosa HD is just the sheer weight of it. It's a little lighter than the Cuda HD, so on a day when I'm dragging over rocks or a portage, or even after a long day on the water when I'm trying to get it on top of the truck instead of on the trailer, you know, 10 pounds makes a difference to me. Yeah, if I fished open water, saltwater bays, you know, big lakes, stuff like that, I would definitely have to lean toward the Cuda HD. I mean, it's just an exponentially fast boat to me. There's not a whole lot of effort to paddle it, you know, but it's big enough that I can do this. I can stand up, I can still fish it comfortably, which is first boat in the Cuda line that I've been able to do that in. So this boat has very much impressed me with its fishability. But like I said, for the just in comparison now, you know, the Coosa HD, moving water, things like that, the Cuda HD, you definitely want to think about it for your salt water, your flats, your bays. Yeah, I would handle big open water with this, no problem, don't get me wrong. I've had the Coosa HD through class 3 plus white water, you know, but the Cuda HD, just being able to have the speed that you need to get out of trouble if you need to, but yeah, you could handle open water ways, but you don't have the maneuverability from moving water, to me. That's why I like the Coosa HD in the moving water. But it's an excellent boat, very stable, very fast. You know, they're both great choices. I'll put up the specs here on the screen so you can kind of compare them, you know, number to number. But, you know, just fishability, you can't go wrong. But I want you guys to paddle them to do what you do in them so that you make the correct decision. You know, the worst thing in the world is spending this amount of money and not being happy with your purchase. So do me a favor, you know, try to get on them in the water if you can. If you're around me, I'll bring them out. I'll do my best to get you in them so you make a good decision. But I hope this video has helped a little bit. Y'all take it easy.